some of us the Lord has been calling us, but we have not been willing to do it. I want you to surrender to the Lord. Tell the Lord, here I am, Lord. Use me for these times and seasons. I want you to surrender. Tell God, it is all about you. It is you that I need. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we worship you. Father, we surrender. We surrender our will to your will. We surrender our emotions. We surrender our feelings. We surrender our bodies. We surrender our spirit. We surrender our mind. We surrender our eyes to you. We surrender our tongues to you. We surrender everything that we have to you. We surrender our businesses to you. We surrender the church to you. Jesus, take over. Holy Spirit, take over. Oh Lord God Almighty, thank you because of the word. As I speak the word of God, may it come with clarity to your children. May they receive it in the name of Jesus. Father, I humble myself that the Holy Spirit may use me. Holy Spirit, I surrender my everything to you, that you may use me as your vessel for your glory. All the glory goes back to the Lord. And it is in Jesus' mighty name we pray and we believe. Can somebody clap to the Lord? You can have your wonderful seats. May God bless you. Today I want to go straight to the Word of God. I want us to read from the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, from verse 4. Today I want us to speak about the Holy Spirit. Say the Holy Spirit. Wale hawaelewi kizungu, tunaongea kuhusu Roho Mtakatifu. Unajua Roho Mtakatifu amekuwa amepuziliwa kwa wakati mrefu. Some of us, we understand about God the Father. We understand about God the Jesus. But we never understand about the Holy Spirit. Kwa ile sababu inafanya kanisa ikuwe so weak. It is because we have neglected the Holy Spirit. Watu wengi tulipokuwa tunakuwa hata mimi tuliogopa sana mambo ya Roho Mtakatifu. Roho Mtakatifu alichukuliwa kama kitu. Watu wengi ukisikia wakisema wanasemanga nilisikia kitu ikiniambia. We never want to acknowledge the Holy Ghost. Wengine walituambia tunanena na ndimi na hatujui kuziinterpret kwa nini. Na wengine wetu tukapuzilia the ministry of the Holy Spirit. We called him the Holy Ghost. Na hii ghost inatutia hofu sana. Tunashangaa hii kitu ni nini? Hii kitu ni kitu gani hatuelewi. Lakini wacheni nianzie na kusema ya kwamba the Holy Spirit is the same as God and Jesus Christ. There is the Godhead. What were the new believers? Let me teach you one thing. That our God is three in one. We have God the Father. We have God the Son. And we have God the Holy Spirit. When we went to hatuna shida na baba. Actually, kila wakati tunamuomba baba. Watu wengine hatuna shida na Jesus. We keep on calling on Jesus. But most of us, we have not understood about the Holy Spirit. So many of us, when we think about the Holy Ghost, we only think of speaking in tongues. But let me tell you today, the Holy Spirit is more than speaking in tongues. Amen. The Holy Ghost is more than we have discovered. Actually, the Holy Ghost wants to reveal himself to the church. If at all we are going to do great exploits, we have to receive the power of the Holy Ghost. We have to accept him as a persona. Let me give you a testimony of myself. I grew up in the mainstream religion. Na huko hatukukubalishwa kujua juu ya Roho Mtakatifu. But I went to the fellowship and I found that these people are different from me. And I wondered, why are these people different from me? Wakiingia katika maombi wanaomba na hawabembelezi kuomba. If it comes to the things of holiness, these people are string a holy life. And I asked myself, what don't I have? Amen. And I started seeing it is the Holy Ghost. And I got so fearful myself of receiving the Holy Spirit. And because I used to pray in my wardrobe because of certain reasons, I was a small girl. I was so tiny, I don't see any girl who is tiny here than the way I was before I got married. So I used to close myself in my wardrobe and I could pray. And that day, I made a decision, I need the Holy Ghost. This Holy Spirit whom Jesus promised. And I have shut myself in the wardrobe. And I told God, Leonie, Leonie, you have to fill me, Lord. Fill me with the Holy Spirit that I can be a true witness of Jesus. I was a fearful girl. Singe si mama mbele za watu. Singe weza ku understand the scriptures. Singe weza kuomba 10 minutes. But this time I told God, no, I am here, fill me. It is a promise from heaven. And all of a sudden, oh, I thank God for that day. That wonderful day when the Holy Ghost came upon me and I was baptized again. And there was a witness of speaking in tongues. Mimi kupenda sana kuongea kwa ndimi maana I'm an ordinary person. Lakini ukijazwa na Roho Mtakatifu, there are some orders that have to go. Amen. You know, the Holy Spirit enabled me. I was a young girl. There are battles I fought as a young girl due to his enablement. And today I want to speak to you, even the young people. You need the Holy Ghost in your life. Amen. Unajua kwa nini watu wanang'ang'ana sana kukaa maisha matakatifu? It is because they have denied the power of the Spirit in them. Paul akiandikia Timotheo alimwambia ya kwamba, people shall have a form of godliness. Ukiniangalia hivi. By the way, I know I have a form of godliness. Because nikianza kuteremka hivi, watu wananiambianga, uende utuombee pastor. Uende utukumbuki, hata pengine si kanisani nakuja. Unajua wengine wetu tumekaa kanisani sana. Tunakaa wokovu na tunakaa Kristo. Lakini we have denied the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I want to go step in steps. I have so many things to teach you. But I pray that what I'm going to teach you, you're going to get it. Kenye tunahitaji siku hii ya leo. In order for us to do the exploits, in order for us to see the supernatural, it is the Holy Ghost who does it. Amen. Watu wetu wengine tunafikirianga ni jinsi tunajua kuongea sana. Ni jinsi tunajua kujipresent. Ni jinsi tunataka kuandika hizi notes and presenting them accurately. But it is not about us. It is not about the child of God. It is about the Holy Spirit. And I'm going to teach you some few things. The first thing you have to know, that as God is, as Jesus is, so is the Holy Spirit. Do you see where, when creation was taking place, the Holy Ghost was there. The Bible says, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the surface. Amen. He's the one that makes things become. Wengine wetu tumekuwa tunajiuliza, what am I called to be? But you have denied the access of the Holy Ghost. You can never become without the Holy Spirit. Let me teach you. He has a personality. For those who are writing, the Holy Spirit has a personality. Can you read from the book of Acts 1, verses 4? What Jesus said to his disciples. The Bible says, on one occasion, when he was still eating with them, he gave them this command. Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift the Father has promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you'll be baptized with the Holy Ghost. This is Jesus Christ giving orders to his disciples. These disciples walikuwa na Jesus for 3 good years. Actually, Jesus had outpoured himself to the disciples for 3 good years. Mukikana mtu miaka mitatu, let me tell you. Come on, this is a leader. You'll be talking like the leader. You'll be behaving like the leader. Jesus had outpoured himself to them. But Jesus tells them, do not leave Jerusalem. Usiondoke Jerusalem. Maana, you'll not be effective if you don't get this gift. Amen. Jesus tells them, do not leave Jerusalem. Until you are endued with power from on high. Amen. It is this power that we need today. If you want to see change, it is the power of the Holy Ghost that we need today. Let us read from the book of Acts 2. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all gathered in one place. Suddenly a sound like a blowing of a violent wind came from heaven, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each one of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues, and the Spirit enabled them. It's the day of Pentecost. I want to read another scripture. I'm just reading. We are going to emphasize on them. Just go to the book of Acts 10:38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the oppression of the devil, because God was with him. Jesus himself, you're going to see it, he was having the Holy Spirit. Actually, when Jesus got baptized, there is a gift that he received. He could not be effective without the Holy Spirit. And the Bible says when he came out from being baptized, heaven opened up and the Holy Spirit descended on him like a dove. It rested upon him. Amen. And from there, Jesus' ministry began. He was taken into the wilderness for 40 days. And the Bible says he returned in the power of the Holy Ghost. And the Bible says how God anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost and power. And wherever he went, he did good. Amen. Are we still following? There is one occasion, and this is the church today. Paul went to the Ephesians in Ephesus, and he found 12 good men who were born again just like we are. The Bible says in the book of Acts 19:1, when Apollos was in Corinth, Paul took the road through the interior and arrived to Ephesus. There was found some disciples, and he asked them, this is what I'm asking you today. And he asked them, did you receive the Holy Ghost when you believed? Paul and Lakutapani, they were believers. Akauliza na nini watu wangu, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed? They answered, no, we have not heard that there is a Holy Spirit. Wengine wetu hatujasikia kuhusu Roho Mtakatifu. Wengine wetu hakuna mtu ametufunza juu ya Roho Mtakatifu. And Paul asked them, when you believe, did you receive the Holy Ghost? I'm asking JBC today and our viewers today, did you receive the Holy Spirit when you believed? Did you? It's good to be. Nataka ujichunguze ndani yako. I know the Spirit of God is speaking to you individually. Did you receive him when you believed? They said, no, we have not heard about him. This is what Paul said. What did you receive? They told him, we received the baptism of John. And he said, it is good you received the baptism of John. But John talked about another. Kuna mwingine Yohana aliongea kuhusu, who was greater than him. Alisema ya kwamba, I am not worthy to untie his races. I am not worthy. He is coming, who is coming after me shall baptize you with power and the Holy Ghost. Amen. There is one, John the Baptist saw. And he said that this one shall baptize you with power and fire. Amen. We need the fire of the Holy Ghost. Kama ujajazo hata ninapoongea ambia baba nahitaji hii gift. It is not anything that you do to receive the Holy Spirit. It is just a surrendered heart. Oh yes. Jesus told the Samaritan woman, and those who are out of you shall come out living waters. Amen. That shall end up to eternal life.